everybody. I'm Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com. Today, we're going to talk about how to mask video to text in Premiere Pro. Let's take a look at the exact effect that we're going to be creating. There it is. Feels like a blast from the past in some cool ways and some just... maybe I'm glad that that era is over a little bit. But we're going to take a look at how to at least do that masking to the text. And maybe we'll throw the animation in there as well. If you enjoy this video tutorial, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you can check out all the Premiere Pro and After Effects video editing tutorials, all the goodness over there on the channel. Let's jump into this tutorial now and check this thing out. So I just have a copy of what you just saw on the screen a moment ago. But what I'm going to do is I have this the hamburger clip here. I'm just going to right click on that and choose new sequence from clip to just throw it into a brand new sequence here. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to take that hamburger movie clip. I'm going to move it up one video track, and we are going to come over here to the new item button right down there, new item, right? And we're going to choose color mat. And I'm going to really just let it be what it is. And we're going to choose to fill the color mat with white. That's, you know, F. Hit OK. And we can name the color, the color mat whatever we want. I'm not going to name it anything. And I'm going to drag it out here onto my timeline. And then I'm going to drag it out so it's as long as the video clip. The key is going to be we need this color mat to be underneath our video because this is what we're going to see around the video. So like here, when we see this, if I change this white color mat to a different color, well, all around my text will change to a different color. So that's actually helpful to know because if the client needs it to be blue or something, well, you just change the color of the color mat. Boom, you've got blue around your masked video. Next, what I'm going to do is grab the text tool over here, or the type tool as Premiere calls it, and we'll just click out here, and I'm going to type in all caps, the classic, and then I'm going to hit enter return, and I'm going to say hamburger. There we go. And I'll highlight this text, just drag out to highlight the text here, and over here I've got all this source text, and I can choose a new font. Now, you want to choose like one of those kind of bubbly looking retro fonts. I think it just works for this video clip that kind of looks like it was shot a little while ago. It just works with the whole vibe of what we got. Something like the typeface Cooper. You can look around online. You can find all kinds of great ones. I'm going to use this typeface here. I believe it's free. It's called Henrietta. I'm going to choose that. You can see that's super cool looking. And I'm going to come down here and attack the sizing slider. I believe, according to my notes, around 225 or so should be great. And yeah, 226, that looks pretty nice. And let's also change the leading. That's this right here. This is kind of like the line height. We're going to change it to negative 70. So we're just going to try to pinch the text a little bit closer. So about negative 70 looks pretty good. And now what we'll do, we'll come down here, we'll grab our selection arrow right here, and we'll just drag this text. We'll drag it around until it kind of snaps to the alignment here in the very middle of our video frame. And just like we did with the color mat, we're going to drag the edges of this text object so that they are as long as our hamburger clip. You see, that looks good. And at this point, all we need to do is drag an effect onto our hamburger clip called the track mat key. So I'm just going to type in here track, and there it is, track mat key. See that right there? Drag and drop that on the hamburger clip, and you can see here the settings are. They show up in the effect controls panel, track mat key, and we're going to choose to change the mat here from none to video 3. So V3, you can see that's the track on which our text object is sitting, so it's going to use that as a mask, and you can see now the video will play behind our text. Now, let's say we want to spice it up a little bit. At this point, if this is all you want to know how to do, you're good to go. You can head out. We're going to have a little bit of fun animating this text mask here. So I'm going to throw some kind of retro-y sounding music underneath this. Let's just grab our little razor tool and zip it off here at the end of our stuff. So you can see we got music that's going to be coming into play here. Now the idea is going to be to animate this mask so it looks like it's zooming out from the middle, coming from nothing and, you know, sitting here at this size. So what we want to do here, underneath the source text, accidentally changed the typeface. Let's get back to Henrietta here. There we go. I'm going to just scroll down here. I'm looking for this little option down here, transform. It's beneath all the fill and stroke and shadow nonsense. We're going to just click on this little arrow to the left of it, and it's going to drop down, position, scale, rotation, opacity, all this stuff. And you might say, well, why are we working with transform here when we could just be working up here on the layer, right? We have position, scale, rotation, opacity, all this jazz. Well, if we edit the actual text properties, we maintain that nice, sharp, crisp, clean edge. Where if we just try to scale it, the edge is going to start to deteriorate pretty significantly with the size to which we're going to be scaling this thing. So here's what we're going to do. We want it to be at 100% scaling, right? This is where we want the animation to stop, if you will, the initial zoom in. So let's hold down our shift key and tap the right arrow key like once, twice. Maybe this animation will happen over 10 frames. I'm going to select, I'm clicking up here into this timeline up here next to effect controls. controls. I'm going to hit my plus button to zoom in a couple times. And I'm going to hit this little stopwatch here to the left of scale, which toggles on the animation. You can see it dropped a keyframe right there. And now we'll just go back to the beginning of this text object, and we'll hit this reset parameter arrow. It's going to drop a second keyframe. Let's just drag it back, make sure it's at the very beginning. And I actually really didn't need to reset the parameter. It was already at its reset value. But make sure you're on top of that keyframe, and we're going to set the scale here to 0. There we go. And now what's going to happen is between that keyframe and the other, you can see that the text is just kind of shooting out from nothing, and its origin is the anchor point, the positioning of that original anchor point. Now, what if you didn't want that? What if you didn't want the text to come like from the left side over there? How do we move that? Well, basically what's happening is the text, if we look here, is aligned to the left. If we just select that text, and we say, you know what, center align that, you can see there's that anchor point right there. Now it's in the middle. And if we just drag this whole text object again to about the middle of our document, there it is. Now if we just play through this animation, we can see it just zooms right up from the middle just like that. So a little finicky there, but just definitely something important to note, and it could be frustrating if you're not sure what's going on there. But don't worry. Now what we're going to do is we're going to move a little bit further down the track, and what we want to happen is eventually when the glass is full of the beverage there, we want this text mask to just blow up in our face and zoom through. We'll probably end up zooming through like the letter L. That's where that kind of center anchor point is. We'll zoom right through there and reveal the video. How do we do that? Well, again, the secret lies down here in scaling. So we're going to choose here to add a keyframe out here, right there. Great. And now we're just going to zoom, or we're going to hold down our shift key and move down the timeline like 1, 2, maybe like 15 frames. So I just hit shift and hold down the right arrow key, you know, press it 3 times. So we move 15 frames, and we're going to set the scaling to something crazy. I'm going to go like 4,000. That looks pretty good. Now you can see what's happening here. This here probably is the L. All right. And if I back up a little bit, yeah, we can see we're zooming to the L, but we're not getting through the L, and we're being left with this big chunk of white. So what do we do? Well, here's what we're going to do. We want to align a position change with exactly where these keyframes are. So I need to zoom in on this a little bit. So I'm going to click right here near these keyframes. So I make sure I select my effect controls panel, hit the plus button to zoom in on these. And you can see our playhead is not exactly lined up with these keyframes. So we can use these little arrows, go to previous keyframe. All right, there we go. We're exactly on the last keyframe. And I think I'll start here. So what I'm going to do is over here on position, I'm going to toggle animation on to drop a keyframe here, and I'm going to start moving my animation. I can move it side to side a little bit, so maybe I'll move it like there, and then I'm going to move it top to bottom a little bit as well. So let's try moving it like maybe like that, and maybe we need to move it over a little bit more. Can we sneak through? There we go. So there's a part of the L where we can sneak right through it, and we can't see any of our mask left over. Now what we need to do is jump back to this previous keyframe. So we're going to hit this previous keyframe, and obviously now our whole mask is out of whack. So we want to make sure we come over here and reset the parameter here. So what's going to happen now is as we kind of race through this mask, the position is going to slide and change in such a way that we zoom right through the letter L, and it gives the illusion that the whole mask completely disappears. And we can just play this from the top here. You can see it works beautifully. Now, maybe the last thing to do would be to select a bunch of the keyframes. You can right click here. We can just choose to like ease these out. That'll just give it a little bit of a fade. And we can select these scales here at the very beginning and also ease them out. And that'll just give us a little bit of a softer landing, if you will, while you kind of force your way through this effect. But it's pretty cool. It looks pretty good. We have that kind of retro zoom and then just a zip right through the letters to reveal the entire full video. So that's really it. We kind of took it a step further than just simply masking video to text. We added that whole animation element. Took a little bit longer than I thought, but you know what? Hey, we had a little bit of fun with it, and maybe you learned something, maybe you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy this tutorial, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to this channel. You can also check me out and follow me on Instagram. I'm over there. I try to, you know, really interact with the good people over there. Send me a message if you have any questions, anything like that. Instagram is a place to be. So for creating this masked video effect using text and even adding the animation here in Premiere Pro, that's it. Get it, got it, good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.